Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today's topic is PSA. What does the report mean? How do I interpret the report? On what PSA parameters do I need intervention? And how do I talk to my doctor or my urologist about my PSA report? Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. I am Dr. Vijayan Govinda Gupta, a urologist and a prostate cancer specialist in New Delhi, India. Today's topic is about PSA. So what does PSA mean? Why is this test being done so often? So there are two components of PSA. So PSA is basically something called as a prostate specific antigen. It is a protein molecule that is produced specifically by the prostate, and in any disease of the prostate, it may be enlargement, it may be cancer, it may be infection. If there is anything that is disturbing the prostate, these antigens levels tend to rise in the patient's blood. So this antigen can be detected through a test in which the patient's blood sample is taken, and this blood levels then can be utilized to understand whether there is something wrong going on with the prostate. Now the PSA is usually utilized in three ways. Either it could be screening. Screening means that you as a patient do not have any symptoms. You have nothing at all to do, but one fine day you decide just to test your PSA to see whether you have cancer or not. Now this approach is flawed, and this approach has a lot of controversies going in. Some professional bodies around the world say that the PSA screening is helpful, while some say that the PSA screening gives rise to undue anxiety and unnecessary treatment in patients. So a few groups say that you should get screened annually or biannually. Some groups say there's no role of screening. As of now, the Indian urologist group is silent on screening, but the majority opinion says that at least a baseline PSA at the age of 50 years is helpful for two reasons. One, that baseline PSA or that one level of PSA can be utilized by the urologist later to judge what the PSA movement is like. Plus, it can help detect prostate cancer early. But is this detection helping in reducing prostate cancer related deaths? The answer is still to come. So that is screening. The second is, you have symptoms, you have had some urinary symptoms like frequency or nocturia, and you decide to go to a urologist who then does a digital rectal examination for you. He feels that there is something that may be wrong with your prostate, and he orders a PSA test. That is not a screening PSA, that is a diagnostic PSA, and this PSA value will then decide what kind of treatment will you get on the basis of that result. And the third is something called as a therapeutic PSA testing, in which you are undergoing some form of treatment, either in the form of dutasteride or in the form of radiation therapy or in the form of oncological therapy for your benign or malignant prostate conditions, and your PSA levels are being monitored by a urologist to see whether the therapy is effective or not. So in all of these three sub scenarios, the PSA reports have different meanings. So there is now, PSA is a range. Range means that there is no one fixed value for PSA. It is not like saying that this man is 50 kgs or this man is 80 kgs. A man may weigh anything between 70 to 90 kgs in a normal weight range. Similarly, the PSA has a range. So the PSA is below 4 nanograms per ml, then that is considered to be the normal range for the PSA. If the PSA goes above 4 and it's between 4 to 10, then that PSA is elevated, and if the PSA is above 10, that PSA is a cause of concern. But at the same time, every PSA that is above 4 is not a sign of cancer. There are a lot of sub-tests like ultrasounds, MRIs, free PSA levels, PSA, pre-pro PSA, which can help the urologist figure out whether the PSA levels are actually normal. So then, for example, a patient with a 78 or a 100 gram prostate who is 65 years old may actually have a PSA of 8, but that PSA levels may be normal. So it is very important that your PSA levels are interpreted by a qualified urologist to let you know whether you require further intervention or testing. So usually if your PSA is below 4, the urologist is not going to order any more tests. If your PSA is between 4 to 10, further testing in the form of an MRI or a PET CT or a digital examination or a biopsy or a free PSA or even PSA observation, any of these five options may be utilized for you. And if your PSA is above 10, then usually the doctor is going to take you in for an MRI or a biopsy to confirm whether you are not harboring any prostate cancer that requires treatment. So if your PSA is elevated, do not worry. Every elevated PSA is not cancer. Actually, it is extremely rare that your PSA may be elevated and you actually land up with a diagnosis of a cancer. But at the same time, proper observation until your PSA is taken back to its normal range, along with care, is required for every elevated PSA report out there. So if you wish to know more about PSA, please like this video and subscribe to my channel. You can always ask me your doubts in the comment section. You could email me. You could always connect with me on Facebook for clearing out more doubts on your PSA levels. Thank you for listening. Thank you so much.